Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers. I'm Naveen. In the previous video, we have seen what is BuddyPress and what are the different settings of BuddyPress, what is BuddyPress component. In the coming video of this video series, we will take each and every component of BuddyPress and I will try to describe it with an example so that it is better clear for you guys. For today's video, I have chosen extended profile field component of BuddyPress. We will see how to use it. Okay, so if you have any questions, you can always comment on the video which I post, and don't forget to subscribe because my subscribers are less. So if you subscribe, it will give me motivation. So let's move on now. So this is our community website, and the first thing here we will do is we will enable user registration so that anybody can register to our community website. For that, I'll go here in the backend, and then in the settings I will click on journal. Here you will find an option called anybody can register. I will enable this option and I will do the save change. Now I will open this site as a non-logged in user in incognito window. Here you can see two links appear, login and registration. So because we are using BuddyX theme, these two links has been added by BuddyX theme functionality. So they added it for us. I will click on register link. Here you can see BuddyPress registration form. And if I click on login, it show me a login form. Extended profile component of BuddyPress provide you an option to create a custom profile data fields, and user can use those data field to describe themselves during registration or during their profile update. So when you enable this option here in the component section, you will find one page under users tab called profile fields, and from here basically you can define your custom fields. For example, I will click on add new field and I will define this field as last name, and I will make it text box. And there is an option here you will notice called sign up. Since I want to show this field on user registration form, I will enable this and I will just save it. There is one more field I'm gonna add called bio. Describe yourself, and I will select field type as biography. You can see there are many different type of field types that basically help us to create custom profile fields. So for biography, I have chosen type as biography, and I will enable this option because I want to show this field on user registration form. If I will not enable this field, then this particular field will be only accessible when users try to update their profile from their profile section. So it will not available on registration form if I will not check this option. Since I want it, I will save it. And now if I check the registration form, there you go. You can see I have name, last name, bio. So now I will register a few users. So I have copied some information here. I will give it Sam. Morrison is the surname. Let's add some bio information. And email ID. I'm giving it a weak password, and then I will click on create sign up. Okay, it says an error, so Let's do it this way. I will have to refill the biofield and then I'll click on complete. Okay, so you have successfully created an account. To begin using site, you need to activate your account via the email we have sent you to your email address. So I have a local email server. So there you can see I got an activation email. Hi Sam, and then this activation email. And in the previous video we have seen, like, if you want to change the formatting of this email, then you can change it from this email tab. Here, if I search the title, you can see here the email data has been written, content has been written, and you can basically do the changes in it. See, it is exactly the same email, and you can add more content to it. And from the users tab, manage profile, I see an option here like which user got registered, and I am, as the admin, can directly activate this user if I want. So now you can see the Sam is a subscriber. Now let's quickly add one more user. I got an email here. I will simply copy this link and open it in the same window from where I registered. I got a form. I will just click on activate. So now my account is activated. There you go. You can see two subscribers. So that's it, guys, for today's video. I hope you learned something new about BuddyPress and the extended profile field component of BuddyPress. If you have any query, you can let me know in the comment section. I will reply to them. In the next video, we will talk about members type of BuddyPress, and we will see what is members type, how to use it. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, and see you in the next video.